वेलकम एवरी वन. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द बैलेंसिंग ऑफ द रिडॉक्स रिएक्शन यूजिंग द आइन इलेक्ट्रॉन मेथड. आइन इलेक्ट्रॉन मेथड इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द हाफ रिएक्शन मेथड एंड दिस मेथड वॉज डिवेलप बाय जेट एंड लॉमेफ इन 1927. बिफोर टेलिंग यू द रूल्स विच आर used for the balancing of the equation by the ion electron method, I will like to mention one thing, that there are some redox reaction that take place in the acidic medium, others take place in the neutral medium, and some of them take place in the basic medium. In this particular lecture, we are going to study the rules and balancing of a redox reaction by ion electron method, which will be taking place in the acidic medium. So let us talk about the rules. The first rule is that first of all you will write down the skeleton equation. Sometimes the skeleton equation is given to you and sometimes the information is given to you and you will have to formulate the skeleton equation. And this skeleton equation is usually an ionic reaction. Ionic reaction mean that the substances involved in the reaction will be written in the form of their ions. So the substances will be written in the form of the ions in that ionic reaction. Second, you will write down the oxidation number of every atom on top of it. So after writing the skeleton equation, now you will mention the oxidation state of every atom on its top. Then third, you will show that which one is the reduction and oxidation half reaction. So you will show the oxidation and reduction half reactions then, that which half is actually the reduction half and which half is actually the oxidation half of the reaction. Then fourth, you will separately balance both halves. You may balance oxidation half first or you may also balance the reduction half first, but both halves will be balanced separately. And when we say that both half are balanced, actually this balancing is with respect to mass and charge. Means you will balance the number of atoms on both sides of the equation and you will also balance the charge on both sides of the equation by adding or removing the electrons. When the both half will be balanced, then you will balance the on the next step, mean on the fifth step, you will balance the net electron gain and loss. The number of electron gained during the reduction half should be equal to the number of electrons lost during the oxidation half. And when you will balance both net gain, electron loss and gain, then after balancing both halves and balancing the net electron gain and loss, you will add both these half reactions. And when both the half reactions will be added, the final balanced equation will be obtained. So these are the rules for balancing of a equation by the ion electron method. How the hydrogen and oxygen will be balanced? This is a very important question. So you will add the oxygen atoms with the help of water. You will add water molecules to the side having the lesser number of oxygen atoms to balance oxygen on the both sides. And the hydrogen atom, in case of the acidic medium, they are balanced by using the H positive ions. So you will add H positive ion to that side of the equation which has lesser number of the hydrogen atoms. Now let us balance an equation using the ion electron method. Suppose that we have an equation which is IO3 negative 1 plus AsO3 negative 3 goes to form I negative 1 plus AsO4 minus 3. Now this one is the skeleton equation which is written in the form of ion, and such kind of equation in which the reactants and products are written in the form of their ions, that is called as the ionic equation or ionic reaction. So this one is basically a redox reaction written in the form of the ions. Now first of all, you will show the oxidation state of the atoms on top of them. In case of IO3 negative, look at this carefully. I am going to write down it like this. IO3 overall it is negative 1. One oxygen atom is minus 2. So 3 will be having the charge minus 6. And in order to make it equal to minus 1, iodine must carry the charge plus 5. Similarly, in case of AsO3 minus 3, the overall charge is minus 3. One oxygen atom is minus 2, so 3 should be equal to minus 6. And in order to make it equal to minus 3, the arsenic should be equal to plus 3. And here, iodide is carrying the charge negative 1. It is in the form of ion. So the charge on iodine atom, it is minus 1. That will be its oxidation state. In case of AsO4 minus 3, simply, it is overall minus 3. One oxygen atom is minus 2 into 4, it will be minus 8, so arsenic should be plus 5. Minus 8 and plus 5, the overall charge will be minus 3. So after writing down the skeleton equation in the form of ions, we have mentioned the oxidation state on top of each atom. When you will be writing down in exams, you will write each step separately, but I have written the equation once and I will perform the steps using this single equation. But when you will be writing down in the exams, you will write each step separately, writing its own equation. Now, which atom is oxidized and which one is reduced? Iodine has changed from plus 5 to minus 1. So, plus 5 to minus 1 simply means that there is a decrease in the oxidation state, and we will say that it is the reduction part of the reaction. And the arsenic has changed from plus 3 to plus 5. As the oxidation number has increased, so it will be the oxidation part of the reaction. Now you have mentioned that which part is the oxidation half and which part is the reduction half. And now each half will be balanced separately. It is not mandatory that the oxidation half should be balanced first or reduction half should be balanced first. You can balance any half first and the second one at last. You can balance oxidation first, then reduction, or you can balance reduction first, then oxidation. So let us start with the oxidation half. First of all, we are going to balance the oxidation half. The oxidation half is AsO3 minus 3. Goes to form AsO4 minus 3. First of all, you will balance those atoms which are other than oxygen and hydrogen. And here the atom other than oxygen and hydrogen is arsenic, and it is balanced on both sides already because each side has one arsenic atom. So it need not to be balanced. Now this side has 3 oxygen atoms while this side has 4 oxygen atoms. And I have already mentioned during the rules that the oxygen are balanced using the water molecules. So you will add the water molecule to the side having the lesser number of oxygen atom, and we will add water here, H2O. Now both sides they are having 4 oxygen atom, but the problem is Now the hydrogen are imbalanced. This side has two hydrogen while the right side has no hydrogen atom. So in order to balance the hydrogen atom, you will add 2H positive ion on this side. Hydrogens are balanced by adding the H positive ion, and oxygen is balanced by adding the water molecules. Now you can see that mass on both sides is equal, or you can say that number of atoms on both sides, they are equal. Now you are going to balance the charge. Here the total charge on the left hand side is minus 3 as water is neutral. But here the charge is minus 3 and plus 2. So minus 3 plus 2, the overall charge is minus 1 on the left hand side. This side is minus 3 and this side is overall minus 1. So you will add electrons to balance the charges on the both sides. If you want to make this side minus 3 means equal to the left hand side, then you will have to add the 2 electrons here. So the two after the addition of the 2 electron, now this side is, it is minus 3 and it was overall minus 1. Now it is, this side is also minus 3. So in this way, the charges on both sides, they are also balanced. So first of all, you will balance the number of atoms and then you will balance the charges. But all these steps, they will be written separately. Now let us balance the reduction half. What is the reduction half? It is IO3 negative 1 goes to form I negative 1. Now the atom other than hydrogen and oxygen is iodine, and it is balanced on the both sides. It need not to be balanced. But the left hand side has 3 oxygen atom while the right hand side has no oxygen atom. So in order to balance the oxygen atom, you will add 3 water molecules on the right hand side. After adding 3 water molecule, now the number of hydrogen on both sides are disturbed. Right hand side has 6 hydrogen while left hand side has no hydrogen atom. So here 6 H positive will be added. After the addition of 6 H positive, now you can see that atoms on both sides, they are balanced. Now you will have to balance the charge. It is plus 1 into 6 plus 6 and it is minus 1. So plus 6 and minus 1, overall it will become plus 5. Left hand side is plus 5. While the right hand side, that is water is neutral and one iodine is minus 1. So right hand side is minus 1. Now my dear students, you will have to balance the charges on the both sides. This side is minus 1 and this side is plus 5. The side which is more positive, to that side we add the electrons in order to balance the charge on the both sides. So in this case here, 6 electrons will be added. After the addition of 6 electron, the charge on the 6 electron and 6 H positive, that will be cancelled. This side will be having overall minus 1 and it will be also minus 1. So the charge on both side, that is also balanced. Now after balancing the atoms and charges on both sides of this reduction half as well, we will balance the net electron gain and loss. You can see that in the oxidation half, the loss of 2 electron takes place, but in the reduction half, the gain of 6 electron takes place. So in order to balance this, you will have to multiply this oxidation half with 3. You will have to multiply it with 3. And when you will multiply it with 3, there will be loss of 6 electron and gain of 6 electron. Both the net gain and net loss of the electron will be balanced. So let us write down the reaction after the multiplication with 3. It will become 3H2O plus 3ASO3 minus 3 goes to form 3ASO4 minus 3 plus 6H positive plus 6 electrons. After multiplication with 3, this equation becomes like this. Now what is the reduction half? Write it down. It is 6 electrons plus 6H positive प्लस IO3 नेगेटिव 1 गोज टू फॉर्म आई नेगेटिव प्लस 3H2O. नाउ बोथ हाफ आर बैलेंस्ड, इवन द इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंड लॉस, नेट इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंड लॉस दैट इज ऑल्सो बैलेंस्ड. नो यू सिंपली यू विल एड दीज टू हाफ्स एंड यू विल कैंसल द स्पीशीज दैट कैन बी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वेन यू विल एड दीज टू हाफ्स, देर आर 6 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ऑन द प्रोडक्ट साइड एंड 6 इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑन द रिएक्टेंट साइड, सो दे विल बी कैंसल्ड. नाउ देर आर 6 प्रोटॉन्स ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड एंड 6 प्रोटॉन्स ऑन द राइट साइड, दे विल ऑल्सो बी कैंसल्ड. देर आर 3 वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड, 3 वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑन द राइट साइड, दे विल ऑल्सो बी कैंसल्ड. द रिमेनिंग इक्वेशन बिकम्स नाउ 3 मोल्स ऑफ AsO3 नेगेटिव 3 प्लस IO3 नेगेटिव 1 goes to form 3 moles of AsO4 minus 3 plus I negative 1. So my dear students, this one is the balanced chemical equation. By the ion electron method,